Cuba Información.
No me digan más mentiroso, no me digan más.
On the 23rd of May, the Cuban dissident, ex-prisoner Diosiris Santana, described a scene of police brutality towards several of his compatriots. They were dragged on the floor, hit in the face and arm. One has been left with a broken nose and foot. Anyone would think that his accusation was directed against the Cuban police. But no. Santana told of the actions of the municipal police of Madrid during the arrest of four Cuban ex-prisoners camped outside the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Spain. "I'm concerned by this situation. I had never seen this in Spain," said another one of the so-called dissidents, Francisco Bacallao, referring to the police violence. A somewhat cynical comment in this case, given that Bacallao has lived for many years in Madrid, where just days before, the national police had evicted, with much greater violence, dozens of people from the 15th of Mayo movement in the nearby Puerto del Sol. The Cubans were protesting due to the end of the financial support that 115 ex-prisoners and their 647 family members had received from the government of Spain during 2010 and 2011. This was following an agreement with the previous government and the Catholic Church in Cuba. Recall that within days of arriving in Madrid, the exiles broke with the government of Rodrigo Zapatero, which had welcomed them. Several others travelled to Brussels with assistance from the opposition Popular Party to defend the hardline policy and sanctions against Cuba contained in the so-called European Common Position.
Un maquillaje del gobierno cubano que persigue un solo objetivo entre tantos otros, pero fundamentalmente un objetivo, que le retiren la posición común. La posición común que se adoptó cuando el gobierno de Aznar en el 1996. Y creo que es una aberración retirarle la posición común a Cuba.
Ironically, now the Popular Party is in government and at the height of budget cuts, it has decided not to extend the economic aid, finishing the 18 months of provision signed in the host agreement. The Popular Party has even rejected a proposal from the group Union Progress and Democracy to allocate 2.5 million euros to these Cubans. And so it is that those who call for the establishment of a capitalist free market in Cuba are now being devoured by it in Spain. In April, one of them, Alberto Santiago de Buchet, committed suicide in the Canary Islands. His family stated that he could not cope with the uncertainty following the announcement of the end of financial support. Most of this group has experienced economic hardship. Barbara Pura Yurubi Dueñas, a family member of one of the exiles, wrote in desperation in a letter that she may lose custody of her daughter as she was financially unable to look after her. Several members of the group have expressed their desire to return to Cuba. For others, however, the solution is in the United States. One of the ladies in white, Sabina Martin, demanded a few months ago to be taken there. "Since we came to Spain, none of what we were promised has been fulfilled by this government. We want to go to the United States where democracy and human rights are truly defended." She continues to be presented in the Spanish media as a fighter for human rights in Cuba. The website of Union Progress and Democracy Party has made opposition to Castro a key tenet of its politics and has supported several of the dissidents. It describes Sabina Martin as a freedom fighter and a woman with great common sense. Let's review some examples of her common sense. In June 2011, Martin was expelled with her family from the centre of the Spanish Commission for Refugee Aid, CREAR, in the city of Malaga for physical aggression, including threats and insults to workers, taking alcohol and knives into the centre and not attending employment workshops. Sabina Martin told the Spanish news agency EFE that behind her expulsion from CREAR, centre of Malaga, was, of course, the Cuban government. Martin's husband, showing the same common sense, accused the CREAR of expelling the family by a military deployment.
y el director del centro buscó una orden ministerial y nos sacó con un despliegue militar.
During their tent protests in Madrid, Sabina Martín claimed that her and her family's lives were in danger.
Bueno, nos amenazaron, nos dijeron que nos iban a dar candela, y esto es por eso que yo digo que la vida de nosotros aquí en este país peligra. Peligra la vida de nosotros, porque todas esas cosas que nos han hecho para provocarnos y para que sucedan estas cosas. Es por eso que yo le pido a cualquier persona que pueda ayudarnos a sacarnos de este país, que nos saque.
The Miami media even reported that undercover agents threatened their safety.
En los últimos días la situación se ha agravado porque aseguran que agentes encubiertos se están acercando a la dama de blanco Sabina Martín y temen por su seguridad.
The lady in white also blamed the Cuban government for her current situation, for not having informed its citizens about the economic problems in Europe. In Cuba, no one knows that in Spain there are so many unemployed and things are so bad, she told the press, adding that had she known, she would not have agreed to come. Anyone who watches Cuban television, which reports almost daily about unemployment in Europe, will know this is a ridiculous comment. Those who have always accused the Cuban media of exaggerating the problems of capitalism now complain that they don't do enough. The accusation is absurd and can be disproved simply by watching Cuban television, whose news programs on the crisis and unemployment in Europe are almost daily. Despite being a grotesque case, the drama of this group is the repetition of an old story. The political utilization of a group of people who the US government financed and organized as a battering ram against the Cuban government, the European right-wing institutions and media which used them to justify the policy of sanctions against Cuba, and a group that has now been left stranded. The names of many of these people, like Diosiris Santana, the same man who denounced the violence of the municipal police of Madrid, appear in manifestos supporting the most extreme positions against their own country. For the maintenance of Europe's common position, the ban on travel to Cuba from the United States, and ultimately the economic blockade of the island. It's an old story repeated for over 50 years, first in Miami, now in Madrid.